today's festival day also. Sankranti and Pongal. Now, on this memorable occasion, and also on the eve of Tyagaraja Aradhana, which falls on 17th of January, in 2 days. So I feel it is my pleasure and my fortune also to speak about the greatest Vagekara India has produced, that is Tyagaraja. Nobody can equal him. Because after and many of musicians know it, and after research in his compositions, I find, you know, he is so great that Rama has talked to him. So whatever he spoke was Rama's words. So that's the greatness of Tyagaraja. Now, if any of you do not know Carnatic music, then most of them, most of you, I think, you know Carnatic music. Okay. I will not go into the technical points more, but I will elaborate certain great things which he has done.
Don't make noise. You cannot listen Masterji's word, okay?
I'll keep my singing first. Shobhilu Saptaswar, Shobhilu Saptaswar, Shobhilu Saptaswar, Sundarula Parimpare Manasa, this is in Jagan Mohini Ragam. Sajama Panisa, Sani Pamagaisa. This is Arohana and Avarohana of this ragam. He says, you know, there are seven notes in music all over the world. It is the same. They call them by different names, that's all. So, seven notes, that is, seven swaras are sa, ri, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni. He says, you worship all these seven notes, you see. Nobody has said like that before him. Why I tell you? This is actually Nada Upasana Paddhati, which he has described in his Kirtana. Nabhi Hritkantha Rasana, Nabhi Hritkantha Rasana, Nasaluna, Nasaluna, Yanjuna. That is from Nabhi, Hridayam, Kantham, Nasam, Nasikam, and all up to Sahasraram. There are seven chakras in human body. So, the Nadam travels from Nabhi till Sahasraram. The whole body will be surcharged with Nadam, that is Omkar. Om is the only syllable which is Parabrahman, that is the ultimate goal which anyone should reach. So, Omkaram, Omkar Upasana is actually Nadopasana. So, Tyagaraja was the greatest Nadopasana. And he described Lord Rama, his Ishtadevam, in another Kirtana as a Nada Swarupa. Nada Sudha Samhiranu Nada Akriti Aye Pranavanada Sudha Rasam Viranu नराकृति आए प्रणवनाद सुधा रसमिलनु वेद पुराणारम शास्त्रानुल आधार महीन नार सुधा रसमिलनु नराकृति आए प्रणवनाद सुधा all gods, for instance, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva are in Omkaram itself. Om consists of three letters, A, U and Om, Makara. A stands for creation, that is Brahma. U is Sthitikaraka, that is Vishnu. And Ma is destroyer, he says, but it's not. He engulfs in himself all the creatures. That is the greatness of Maheshwara. So, this is Omkara. So, any god is actually embodied with Omkara. So, that's how he describes Rama also as a Nada Sharira. Then, he has created many kirtanas in all the popular ragas which are very popular all over the world. There is Kalyani, Hori, Shankaravaram, Harharapriya, Kambhoji, and like that. I will not go deep into those things because there are very big kirtanas also, Vilambakala kirtanas as well as Madhyamakala kirtanas, which will take a lot of time. So, one such kirtana I take in Shankaravaram, where he depicts, you know, the yogi principles. Manasu swadhina maina aghanuni ki mari mantra अगनुनीति मनसु स्वाधीन मैना तनुतानु काजनी यंचु manas, that is mind, then this is a necessity for mantra or tantra. So, when can anybody say that after one reaches only the topmost place, then only he can talk like that. The next point is, Taru, body. Always we all think that I am the body. Actually, in Shastra, we will not accept. In Advaitam, body is also Parabrahma. But in Dvaitam and Vishishta Advaitam, they don't say that. So there are several ways of reaching God. So here, he says, you know, in Dvaitam they say, I am not the body, I am not Manas and all these things. So I have only the soul, that is Atma. That is it. Then he says in the Anupallavi, Tanu, Tanu means Shariram. Tanu, Tanu Kadani. When he says he is not his body, then that means he knows that he is the Atma or the soul. Then there is necessity for him to do any tapas or penance. That beautiful lines are there in this Gita. So this is one aspect of this Gita. And I will tell you, it's a simple kirtana, but in that, his greatness is known. Kadharapri Raghav. Sarigama Padanisa, Sanida Pamagarisa. This is the Raghav. Ramani Samana Nevaru. This line, there is no poetry in this. Ramani Samana Nevaru, who is equal to you? Anybody can say, you can say, I can say, nobody, anybody can say. But what is there in that? It's only one line. Ramani Samana Nevaru. In Sahityam, the expression which he has given is complete, over. If he wants to give any other expression to that line, he has to write another line also. For Sahityam, that is there. But in Sangeetam, what he has done? Ramani Samana Mevaru. This is the first line. Ramani Samana Mevaru. This is the second Sangeeti. Rama, he stresses on each word of that particular line. For Rama, he gives so many sangatis.
Rama ni samana mevaru.
Now, stress for Rama.
Rama ni samana mevaru.
For me, that's how he builds up, you know, Sangeetam.
Rama ni samana mevaru.
Samaram. So, for that particular line itself, he has given so many expressions to each word. That is through Sangeeta. Only music. Music can do that. So, he has built kirtanas like that with so many sangatis of that particular raag. And deified them, I say, because that is godly, everything. Here in this, at this instance, I want to give the background of what Tyagaraja is. He was born in a family of five generations of Rama Bhaktas. Five generations. He is the fifth generation boy. His father was Rama Brahma. His father's name was Rama Brahma. His mother's name was Sitamma. So in one kirtana he says, no,
Sitamma Mayam Shri Ramudu Maku.
Reality also.
This is Shlesha, they call him okay. Sahitya. That means, indirectly he is telling about his father and mother also. And he considers Rama and Sita as father and mother. So this is various in his lyrics. This is in Vasant Raga. Then, one more in Kanarapriya.
Pakkala nilavadi koliche musada baga tilpaga rada ah ah ah. Pakkala nilavadi
stand by his side. That is it. Yes. Visualize Pattabhishekam scene of Rama. You will see so many people around him. Pattabhishekam, Rama, and on the left side Sita, and on the right side Lakshmana, and at the bottom here his feet, holy feet, Anjaneya. So, I have also written a Kirtana of this, based on this point only. Now here he says, you can stand by his side. Then in Anupala he says, Sukkarayani Gerumo Kala. Sukkarayani means moon. We call him Ramachandra also. His original name was only Rama. But we call him Ramachandra, Ramabhadra, so many names. Ramachandra means he gives coolness to the mind. That is shantam to the mind. That is mana. So there are several points if you go deep into the subject. Sudati sitam ma saumi mitri ramura iru pakara nilavari. Only Sudati, that is Lekheri, sitama and Saumitri, that is Lakshmana. Nobody else can stand by his side. So he is so supreme. So, like this, there is another kirtana also in the same topic. There are several kirtanas he has written, and the history says, you know, that he has written 24,000 kirtanas, just as 24,000 shlokas in Ramayana. But no, nothing is available today. Many of them are missing. So, that kirtana is him. Samukha nanila kalbuna kamala nana This ragam is Kokila Bharati, a genium of Matabhairi. Sarima padasa sadanida pamanigarisa. It's so complicated. Then he has written beautiful lines. Samukha Narati, close to him. Who can recite? Samukha Nanila Kalbuna Kamala Nana. He is Kamala Nana. Then in Anupalavi he clarifies this. Kshama Kalbu Bhutanaya Lakshmanadi Mahatmulake Gani Anyulaku Samukhana Nilva Kalbuna. So, Kshama Kalbu, Kshama is, that is patience. Lot of patience is for Mother Earth. So, Shastra say that. And she is born from actually mother Earth only, Sita. So Kshamakalpu Bhutanaya. Lakshmanadi Mahatmulake Gani Anyulaku Samukhananibhavana. Same subject actually. But there are several kirtanas like this which are close, but this kirtana most of the people do not know. Then there are certain things, you know. It's a great experiment by Tyagaraja. There is Arohana Arohana. With that he has created Pallavi of Sanskritas, which is very, very difficult. Guru Lekhaya Tumanti Bhumiti Teliyaga Boru. This is Gauri Manohari. Sarsa Sanira Pallavi, actually Arohana. Sa-sa-sa-ni-ra-pa-ma-ga-pa-ma-ga-di-sa-ri-ni-sa. It's actually Aurohana. Guru-le-ka-ye-tu-an-ti-bu-ni-ti. First line.
తెలియగబోదు రిగమ పదాని.
యూ కెన్ రైట్ లైన్స్ ఫర్ ఓన్లీ ఆరోహణ అవరోహణ, ఇట్స్ వెరీ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్. దట్ మీన్స్ బిజినెస్ ఆఫ్ త్యాగ. దెన్ అనదర్ కీటా
తత్వమిడుగ తరమా పరతత్వమిడుగ తరమా పరతత్వమిడుగ తరమా.
తత్వం మీన్స్ ఫిలాసఫీ. తత్వమిడుగ తరమా, హూ కెన్ నో? పరతత్వము హీ సేస్ నో. దిస్ ఈజ్ యాక్చువల్లీ గరుడ ధ్వని రాగం. సదా పరగరి సమోహణ ఇన్ అవరోహణ. And Avarohana is Chakravana.
Sarigama Padani Sadapagari Sarigama Padani.
What a beautiful way of creating, Pita. So, hats off to Chakravaja. Nobody can imagine like this. And one more thing is,
Ore Zu Kutsu Chedi Nyayama.
Was it like slightly on feet? So he says, you know, he says, Rama, Ore Zu Kutsu Chedi Nyayama. Why do you do it like that? Why don't you come to me and bless me? That's the meaning.
Ore Zu Kutsu Chedi Nyayama.
There are several great salient points in Tyagaraja's creations, and if I go deep into it, it will be completely technical, so I don't want to. Now, Amritwali will sing two Tyagaraja Kirtanas.
We should get an opportunity to hear your complete Kruti.
Actually, my Varasattam, that is, the Sangeetam was completely imbibed by my older daughter, and this is the third daughter. She also composes like me. Tremendous knowledge of classical music also. Vachaspati Ragam, that is 64th Melakatta of the 72 Melakatta.
He just wanted me to introduce the Pallavi and Anupallavi of Kirtanas, which he, Tyagaraja Swami, great saint Tyagaraja Swami, has created. So many compositions and rare ragas which nobody has touched. So I will just sing the Pallavi and Anupallavi of two such in Hamir Kalyani, first I'll sing Hamir Kalyani.
మాను మోదే రా తన వరణి అభిమానము నేగా
Very close to